Hello and welcome along to day 5 of the Rooms of Wonder live book tour, except today isn't live. As you can probably tell, I have pre-recorded today's video just because a few family things came up and I knew it was going to be impossible to do a live, so I did a here's what I made earlier kind of situation, and I've recorded this beforehand. So welcome along. Hi, nice to see you. I know that you're watching. We are celebrating my new book, Rooms of Wonder, which is my new adult colouring book. And today we are gonna colour a wee section from this page, which is like a cabinet of curiosities with like little galaxies and some solar systems, planets, just like loads of really cool cosmic things in jars in this little cabinet, obviously on the other side of the Wizard's Workshop. If you haven't got your copy of the book yet, I know loads and loads of people haven't, don't panic, you can order it now. But I've also got a download that has the wee extraction that we're gonna color on it. So you can get the free download over on my website. I'll pop a link in the description to this video, and you can grab that and print it out and color along at home until your book arrives. Think of it as an inky warm up. Today I'm going to be colouring with my Prismacolor pencils. Now I often find these quite smooshy, but somebody asked me about them the other day. They're very soft, very kind of unctuous, lovely to use. I sometimes struggle with small details with a very soft pencil because I push quite hard, but I thought we'd give it a go and try it out. So if you are thinking about getting some Prismacolors, I can show you how I find them and that can maybe help you make your decision. Right, let's get going. So this is the page that we're going to colour, and we're going to do this little section of bottles here. I'm going to zoom in. You can obviously join in on your download, but I've got the book, so I'm going to do it here. And we're going to do the same 4 wee bottles that you would do if you had the download. I'm going to do these, I feel like I'm kind of repeating myself, but a pinky purpley palette. I just think that works really nice for space things. I've had a few people ask me for a space themed book, and whilst that's a lovely idea, I do worry it would be a bit black. But this is how I would tackle space. I would definitely go down this sort of pinky purpley galaxy route. Oh, that pencil's just, the leads are falling apart in these. I think I might have dropped them or something savage. Anyway, there we go. So I am using my Prismacolors, which, as I mentioned, I find very soft, but nice, but just sometimes a bit tricky for smaller details. But what I'm going to do is lay down a first colour, and then they're really beautiful for blending. If you are a fan of blending your coloured pencils and doing some really nice things with shading, then these are great pencils for you. If, like me, you're more of a fan of small details and quite graphic colouring, so like, I don't know, getting those wee stars perfectly yellow and things, they're maybe not the best for you. But you'll see, you'll see. Right, so I'm just gonna add a wee bit of purple in here. I think I'm gonna do all the jars sort of 2 colours in the body of the bottle or the jar, and then the coloured elements. Next one, I'm gonna do more pink, actually. I think I'm gonna do all the backgrounds first and then go back in and do the little spacey elements. So hopefully you've joined me for the first 4 days of this book tour. We have done a bit of live coloring every day, 5 different pages. If you haven't got your book, there's the downloads on the website. There'll be a link to that, as I said, somewhere near this video. And you can grab 3 free downloads. There's 2 full pages and then 1 that's like a medley, like a little buffet of little snacky bits from 3 of the different pages that we'd worked on. So for bits like this, these pencils are actually nice because you can do a good, they're easy to blend. Like, there's just so much pigmenty color to them. It's like, it's not difficult. I'm not having to push hard. It's just nice. I might actually go over that with a pale pink and see how that goes. and blend it out a little bit. Oh yeah. So if you don't have a blender pencil, I sometimes just use a lighter shade or a white, and it works kind of just the same way. There we go. That's worked really nicely actually. Next one, we'll go back to doing blue. I think we'll make this a very inky blue. And here. So other ways of blending are using a blending solution like Zest It and a wee blending stump, or a blending pen, or something like BB oil, which can be messy but effective. Also, blending pencils, which I kind of like what I just described, when you use a lighter colour to just sort of smoosh the pencils around a little bit. I've actually got a video all about blending, different methods of blending, on my YouTube somewhere. So have a wee peek at that. Right. Noisy outside today. Okay, that is our blue. I might actually, it's a bit flat blue, isn't it? Let's put a wee touch of pink through it. Pink or purple? Lilac. There we go. That's quite nice actually, it just stops it being a bit too flat and blue. Do a few wee bitties. There we go. And then this one here, definitely mega purple. Here's a nice blue. Oh, it's a bit too blue. It's been a bit indecisive there. We'll do this one like this. I think this is actually a little asteroid. An asteroid, some constellations, a few planets. There we go. So I think I'm going to use a paler sort of magenta pink purple to blend this one. This colour here looks quite nice. And then I'll use an even paler one to just blend that all together, flatten it out a little bit. As you can see, I've just gone straight over those stars. That's all right. People worry about going over the lines all the time. I sometimes go over whole elements like that. I just color them in afterwards. Also, if you're going to use a wee bit of metallic or a pen or something, that's, you don't need to worry about doing stuff like that. Let's do this lilac color here. So I always do the background first and then the smaller elements that are on top of it, mainly because then you can tidy it up afterwards, I think. Right, I've gone over the edge there as well. Never mind. Let's do some, what colour will we make the jars? I think blue, probably. I'm gonna grab a blue that I didn't use. Oh, here's a really pale blue. I'm going to make these jars, just give them a little hint of colour in some areas. So this, I always think of this kind of stuff as not so much colouring, but just knocking back the ivory or the white of the paper a wee bit. So it's not that I'm trying to cover every single little white bit of paper here. I'm just giving the impression of a wee shimmer or shine. I think that's the name of a cartoon, Shimmer and Shine. I think that's two little genies. I remember the kids watching that when they were little, well, littler. Right, let's do that. And then this bit, we'd have a wee bit here. And here, and this one. So I tend to do them, the darkest bit, just underneath the overlap, if that makes sense. So where this jar goes underneath this one and this one goes underneath this one, that's going to be the darkest point
also underneath here. Going over the lines again. Do you know what? I had a coffee this morning. I think that's pushed me over the edge a wee bit. And then for the stoppers, you could do them just in the glass. I'm going to do them darker blue, I think. Yeah, different shades of darker blue. I think the inspiration for this came from the kids were watching the BFG. You know, when he gets all, is it dreams that he has in the jam jars? I think that's what I was thinking of, but instead I put little planets in them. Make these a little bit darker. Okay, right, let's do our planets. I'm going to start with the moon, which I am obviously going to do yellow. Will I? Yeah. Or will I do it grey? No, I'm going to do yellow. I've got a little glitter pen that I'm going to do these stars with. I'll show you in a second. Planet, whatever this is, it looks quite earthy. Actually, I'm gonna do this one first. Well, it can be Earth, it's got a ring around it. It's like, is it Saturn that has the rings? I'm gonna do this one greeny blue. Around it, let's do, this is like a pale blue. I don't know if that's going to show up very much. Not massively. Probably do it. I'll do it pink. Yeah, I'll do it pink. Just go for that. That's quite nice actually, because it ties in with the two bottles on either side, and we'll make the back of the ring really dark. Oh, it looks quite nice. Super dark, doesn't it? Let's do this planet, this bright pink, this meteor. So if you push really, really hard, especially with these waxy pencils, if you do it with a cheaper pencil that's a bit harder, you just rip your paper. But with a waxy pencil, what happens is you fully load up the paper, so there's no little white flecks. Has got a name, I can't think of it offhand. This is when I wish we were doing a live, because Emily or someone would know it. Anyway, when I think of it in my head, it's basically like the paper is fully saturated with, is it burnishing? Anyway, it's fully saturated with colouring pencil, and you can't see the little flecks on the tooth of the texture of the paper, so it just looks like that, flat and bold and super bright and poppy. Might do a little bit more pink down here. So some people, when they're working with these kind of pencils, will build up their layers and build up the layers until it does look like that. I quite frankly don't have the patience to do that, but I have seen it done and it looks tremendous. Really, really pretty. Do a wee bit more pink. I like this colour. Like magenta, pink, purple. Oh, and we've got this planet here still to do. Do you know what? I am going to do a bit green and blue, like a kind of version of Earth that has a ring, a Saturn ring around it. Let's do it like this. A blue planet with, oh, actually, let's do it blue on blue. A blue planet with blue land masses. Maybe it's ice. And a wee colour will we do that ring? I want to do it grey, I just don't know if it's going to show up. Here's a grey-green, I'll give it a go, like a sage. Yeah. I'm actually going to make this bit under here just a wee tad darker. I feel like the bottoms of the bottles would be dark. And then we've got our little stars. I'm actually gonna grab, I had some glitter gel pens the other day. Let's try these ones. I've got some, very zoomed in, Pentel glitter gel pens. Let me try them. Let's go with the gold, I think. Look at that. I'm going to scribble that to get the ink to start going. Oh, wow. It's good to go. I'm going to tip the paper in a second when I'm finished, just so that you can see. Oh, I was going to do some of these, actually. How super shimmery and shiny these are. They're cracking. I just use gel pens like this for small details. I know some people do a whole picture with them. I'm probably a bit too heavy-handed to get away with that. So I'm just gonna do a few wee pieces. Super duper. Oh, kicking the lights. I'm gonna move my camera. So there you go, that is the finished. It's so shiny. Oh, they're so nice and sparkly. So that is our finished little section. Where's my messy desk? As you can see, I'm going to kind of do these so that they match with this page here. So it's not a double page spread, but it is quite nice that they have like a bit of an echo in the colour palette and it's quite coherent. I think this will look lovely when it's all finished. I'm going to do the woodwork in like a dark kind of oak colour. And I think to make these jars really pop, I'm going to do the background dark in here. And a dark background just means that the colours will pop forward. But that is for another day. Can you see that shimmeriness? Oh, like, so nice. So nice. So that's us. I really hope you've enjoyed this live book tour, although today wasn't live, but you know what I mean. The 5-day book tour event. It's been so lovely to do some colouring and to see you all coming online and to see all your comments and also to see your colouring. Thank you to everybody who has been sharing their pictures, tagging me in them, using the hashtag Rooms of Wonder. I keep saying Worlds of Wonder, which was the book before, but the two do go hand in hand. So Worlds of Wonder is outdoors, Rooms of Wonder is indoors. But thank you very much for joining me. I hope you have some fun tackling this double page. I can't wait to see all your little galaxy bottles. They'll be so, so pretty. Thank you very much for watching. We're going to do more live videos in the coming months. It's always nice to see you all and to see your colouring, so look out for them. But for now, do check out the Rooms of Wonder book tour page to get your free downloads and to order your copy of the new book. I can't wait to see how you bring all these rooms to life in your beautiful colours. Thank you so much, everyone. Take care.